Welcome to this overview of the Dynamic Transform Toolkit. This toolkit is a collection of tools designed to simplify in-game transformations and object interactions in Unreal Engine, all without needing to write a single line of code. It includes three main features: the transform sequencer for managing smooth transitions between different transformations, an axis rotator, which lets you rotate objects around a customizable axis, and a spline mover for moving actors along predefined paths. By the way, the Dynamic Transform Toolkit works great with our free core interaction system plugin, and it's perfect for handling object interactions and triggering events. If you want to learn more about it, check out our video dedicated to the core interaction system. Now, let's dive into the first feature, the Transform Sequencer. To get started with Transform Sequencer, the first thing I do is copy the default plugin map. This gives me a clean space to work in and demonstrate how the tool is used. Next, I locate the Transform Sequencer blueprint within Plugins Content Folder. Once I've found it, I simply drag it into the world. So we start by selecting these three cubes. So we group them together with Ctrl G and we check out the group actor name. Then we click on the Transform Sequencer and we put in the group actor 14, which it was. We click on the Add Actors from Group Selection button, and now we have a configuration inside the Transform Sequencer. We can do it manually, but this is a much faster way if you handle multiple actors in the editor. Now, what we do is we click on the Add New Transfer Group, and this creates total transforms of two. Now we can interpolate between these two, but right now they're the same. So let's go to the Active Transfer Index 0, and we then ungroup these actors. We scale them, so we create this breadth wall. I'll do a little wider like that. And I'll put it in here. It's okay. And then I click on the Transform Sequencer and I'll just put in one. We can see the different transform groups. Now we go to Transform Index 1 and I'll just decide that we'll scale these two cubes into the, slope. Too much. We'll go here. We will scale this one to create a wall, and again we just press the transform sequencer and we interpolate 0 1 0 1. So now we want to change this inside the game. So for that we have this trigger box, which is already which already works with the transform sequencer reference. And as you can see here, it just gives the reference as the transform sequencer and it calls its blueprint function set desired transform with the ID, which, it can be an absolute ID to which it interpolates. Or if you put in -1, which you can see here, it just goes to the next one sequentially. Okay, so let's try it out. I'll just light, I'll walk through here. And yep, it works. And yep, the parts. So you can use this for any change you want to. You can put in rotation scales. You can even, put in minimal and maximum speed. I think X is for location, Y is for rotation, and Z is for scale. So next tool from the Dynamic Transform Toolkit is the Axis Rotator. It's a tool that lets you rotate any given actors around any axis you provide. So we start by grouping the actors, which in this case are the red green cubes. You want to rotate around the axis. So I made this little tower, and the idea is to make a rotating tower. Then I group them, check the group actor name, which is 28. And then I add it to the configuration with add actors to group selection. And now I have it. So up to this, we need to move the actor axis rotator, and we see the visualization with the red line, which is the axis. If we, rotate it, we can make the axis however we want to, but right now we'll stick to this axis. So when we have that, we use our axis rotator trigger, which you can see it has some trigger options here. Axis rotator, you can do a continuous rotation, you can stop the continuous rotation, or you can rotate to a concrete angle. So let's try it out. We
just move the knee. Yep, and it moves. And right now, I think it was there was a rotate to target angle, which was 60. So now we try out continuous rotation, and we can see that it just infinitely rotates around the axis. So you can use this. You can use this for like rotating stairs or like fans or anything you wish. Now let's check out the actual spline mover, which is the last tool of the Dynamic Transform Toolkit. And what it does is it moves actors around along a predefined spline path. So we just add the actor's references here with clicking. And then we just decide the initial distance on spline. And when we have that, we'll just, you know, try to make our spline a little customized. And when we have that, we just connect this to our spline move reference. So as always, we have a trigger box, which calls start spline movement or stop spline movement. And then we try it. And as you can see, the actress move along spline. There's some options to it. You can decide if it goes back and forth or if it goes in continuous loop. Then I would advise to have a closed loop, so it will always go back to the initial point. And of course there's this rotation options, which, all right, I have to check it. Which are its faces direction keeps rotation, or in faces direction projected. So it's good for like enemies that move along predefined paths, or for some pickups, or for level design that for like platform level design. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in learning more, visit our website to explore all our plugins and tools for Unreal Engine. You'll also find more videos on our channel with overviews and tutorials for each plugin. Be sure to check them out to see what works best for your projects. If you enjoyed this, consider subscribing to stay updated on our latest tools and tutorials. We'd love to have you join us for more. See you in the next video.